everyone, Mirapelli here. It's been a while. Now I am up in Michigan. I hope you can hear me fine. Can't remember if I turned the wind dampener off. Got some mosquitoes out here. But yeah, so sat on the outskirts of Detroit in Westland. I don't know how long I'll be able to stay out here with the skeeters. There's a big river flowing down there. So I was flying yesterday at the school across the street from where I'm living. Did a good crash and broke the antenna here. I'm not sure if that is going to affect the heat transferring ability of this. So I'm just still flying it. I don't have a replacement except for the normal Eachine cloverleaf dome that it comes with. Four point one seven, four point one eight, 4.18. Don't really have too much of a landing pad. Maybe this will work. A little strange. Looks like a bad plug. It's not doing too well. It's one of the Eachine batteries. There we go. Thank you. 3.7, 3.71, 3.72. Oh, where am I walking to? Over here. I still got a little bit left in her. There we go. Oh. You gotta be careful with this. Actually. So as you saw there, that was called panic mode when I saw the tree. And panic mode sometimes results in just losing all brain function. And instead of recovering, like I should be able to, I went into the tree. But this is good. It shows you the durability in this quadcopter here. Because I've tumbled it. That's the first time running into a tree, but you know, I've given its fair share of abuse, and it's still fine. It's perfect. I don't have the rear LED plugged in. I have that at home. Banggood sent me a replacement because the first one bent this way. Once the legs gave way, that was the next thing to give way. So I haven't put it back on until I can figure out new legs for this. And it's not a problem of figuring it out, it's just a problem of doing it. So I just haven't done it yet. But yeah, so, and these blades, I actually haven't broken a blade yet. I have replaced, I think, a couple, maybe three. They were pretty nicked up, you know, but haven't broken anything except for this antenna, and it was one of the cheap ones, I'm not gonna lie. I think I got it off Amazon, I'm not sure, but you know, these don't take the best abuse. That's why when they have their little dome, it makes them a little bit more durable. And you know, the new guys coming out, the square looking ones, and you know, they're black sheep. Well, they're nice, but just once I get better and I actually start using my FPV goggles, then I'll actually think about it. But for right now, I'm still learning line of sight. I want to learn line of sight before I learn FPV. Now see, this guy's pretty dinged up here. What do we got? What? Why are you making noise? What's going on? Oh, well, that's because it was... Alright. Ooh, 4.15 and 4.17. Okay, I need some love. us. So,
drone?
Yeah, drone, quadcopter, yeah. Race.
I couldn't tell. That thing flipped back and forth. That's sweet.
Yeah, I'm still learning.
Yeah,
quite sweet. A lot. It's not easy to control. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really.
Shit, look at you doing pretty good. Pretty durable.
That guy is, yeah. That guy is probably only about. $150, so it's not one of the really expensive ones. If it was like one of the $500-$600 ones, I would be a little bit more worried.
Yeah, I've seen them way up there.
Yeah,
I didn't know you could get them that cheap.
Yeah, this is like a Chinese brand, and so they.
Does it got like the camera and shit on it?
Yeah, I just haven't taken that step yet. I have the goggles at home.
Oh, really?
I just, I'm still...
Hard to do.
Well, they actually say it's easier to fly it that way because you're always looking forward then, and so the controls make better sense.
It's like you're driving it.
But when you're just doing it line of sight, then, you know, when you're going this way, that's going to take you that way, and when you go that way, then that's going to take you. So it's a real brain mind teaser.
Yeah, we used to fly the planes and the big gas helicopters.
Yeah.
Like back in the day, though.
Yeah, even the...
I'm thinking about getting one of them.
Yeah, they have the 3D helis now.
I probably got 5 or 6 planes right here in these trees.
Yeah,
I... See, that thing beeps when you crash?
No, that's when the battery's
going
down. I have a voltage meter on it.
Oh, I thought it was like to find it.
Yeah, so it kind of tells me, like, you know, that sweet spot.
Yeah.
So you don't completely discharge the battery so much.
Yeah, I got an electric car that does that.
Yeah, it's fun. I definitely want to get, like, a Latraxis 4x4. I saw some guys cruising theirs around.
Oh, the trucks?
Back in the trail and, yeah, going through the ponds.
We had a couple of gas ones and an electric one.
Yeah.
Yeah, we used to do all that shit right here. I flew a 6-foot airplane. See them bleachers down there?
Uh-huh.
Took off right there and came up here and it just wanted to turn right. I'm holding all the way to the left and it went all the way around over the road and smashed right into the baseball diamond.
Oh, damn.
It wouldn't turn left. It wouldn't go up. First flight.
Yeah.
The last thing I flew.
I've never flown a plane.
It was big, gas one.
I've seen them.
I still got it. It's still smashed from that.
Actually, expensive hobby.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's cool as hell, though. Yeah, that thing's cool. I'm gonna get one.
Yeah, no, it's it's fun, and then the more people that get it and know how to do it, you can just easily set up a racetrack right here.
I know, I've been seeing that, like drone racing and stuff.
Yeah, I think it's going to get bigger. I mean, ESPN did a drone race last month, I think.
Oh, shit.
Mountain Dew's sponsoring a bunch.
Yeah, so it's about to blow up.
Yeah. It's already...
Prices start going up.
It's already... Yeah. Yeah, for... The name brand ones, you know, all the name brand shit, the prices are, you know, they just don't go down either. Like, you can get, you know, like, the best goggles are the Fat Sharks, so everyone uses, but even finding a used pair of Fat Sharks for below $320, $350 is, no matter how old they get.
Used is probably rare right now.
But you can get Chinese stuff for cheap.
Right.
And it works.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if you could, you know, race with it, but it works for learning.
Yeah, you get the hang of it.
Yeah. And then get something.
That's what I'll do. So I know my kids will want to crash it.
Oh, yeah. Most definitely.
Cool, man.
All right.
Maybe we'll see you down here with one.
All right, man. Enjoy your day. Oh shit, bro. The mosquitoes are out a lot. Got the last pack. Look at the sunset. Well, the colors, at least. Can't see the sunset. It's all the batteries, folks. Though I have to say, I feel like it was a fairly successful night flight. This is the battery that gets stuck. Just gotta push it. Push it, push it, push it real good. So yeah, that was nice. Look at that color. Beautiful. Well, as always, I would like to thank everyone for watching. The few people that do watch. And my few loyal subscribers, sorry that I taken so long to record a video. I do have some video footage of my motorcycle trip from San Diego up to here. I haven't uploaded it to YouTube yet, but I'm getting there. It needs a little bit of editing because there's just a lot of, you know, just driving. I don't know if people really want to just see some raw, unedited 20 minutes of driving. Maybe people do. If you want to see it raw and edited, leave a comment. If not, then I'll just keep doing my thing, and it'll just take longer to upload with editing, just because, number one, I don't really have the time to edit. Number two, I really don't like editing the videos. Because personally, I do like watching other people's videos in the raw. I do like watching the edited videos as well. I think they all have their own flavor, if you will. But so yeah, I feel like I'm learning. I'm getting the turning down, you know, line of sight turning, and, you know, keeping my brain in that orientation of the transmitter here. So all in all, I feel like I'm finally making some progress, and I don't know if I have the copter tuned perfectly. I've never flown a professionally tuned or perfectly tuned quadcopter, so I don't know what to base my adjustments on when I am making adjustments in the tuning and the configuration of stuff. So one of these days I'll fly a professional copter and get to feel what it's like, and then be able to use that knowledge to help my tuning learning ability, which probably comes about last. Thank you, beautiful park, for the awesome times. It's time for dinner and a show. Something fun.